This is an ABC Action News Tracking the Tropics update.
Sponsored by Collis Roofing, the trustworthy roofer of Tampa Bay.
All right, so the 11 a.m. update is in from the National Hurricane Center, and there's not a lot of change, but the one good thing is that it has been downgraded to a Cat 4 storm. Now, it's only 5 mile per hour wind difference, but we'll take what we can get here, right? So 155 mile per hour maximum sustained winds as it continues to create catastrophic wind and storm surge issues across Grand Bahamas today. And with it barely moving at 1 mile per hour to the west, it is going to continue to just absolutely devastate this island throughout the day today. And as we continue to monitor the storm, let me show you the updated track. It doesn't look any different than what we have seen with the previous track. So again, it is still expected at some point to start making more of a northwesterly and then eventually northerly turn, coming dangerously close to the east coast of Florida. So it is important to continue monitoring this, as we have seen with this storm time and time again, as we've been watching it for days on end, that it tends to do some unexpected things. It is nature after all. So again, we're doing the best we can to fine tune this track and continue to keep you posted as to what the impacts will be throughout the state. But the bottom line is, we are just waiting for it to turn north to be absolutely certain of its distance from the east coast of Florida as it continues on its path. As we look at the impacts here across the state with the future cast, I'm going to put this in motion, and you can see on the clock here at midnight tonight, it has barely moved. We are getting some of those outer rain and cloud bands moving across the state, but they don't amount to all that much as far as rainfall totals, especially here in Tampa Bay. And even along the east coast of Florida, they're not getting that much rain here over the next 12 to 18 hours. Once we get into the day tomorrow, this is 8 o'clock in the morning, and you can see some of the heavier rain bands are now affecting the east coast of Florida. But our area, we're starting off with partly to mostly cloudy skies. It won't be until later in the day tomorrow that we'll start to get some of those outer rain bands working through. To us, it's going to seem like a pretty typical summer day with just some enhanced winds for tomorrow if this stays on this path. So again, as we get through late in the day on Tuesday, it starts to get a little closer to being parallel with us, but it really isn't until very early on Wednesday morning that the storm's eye is really parallel with Tampa. At that point, it's getting close enough to bring some extremely heavy rainfall and storm surge to northeast Florida. And again, monitoring Jacksonville for any impacts there that enhanced storm surge for the duration of time that it works its way up the coast. It certainly is going to be a very strong onshore flow. So we're looking at rainfall amounts anywhere from Palm Beach County on north in the 3 to 6 inch range for the most part. Granted, there could be some spots that have some higher localized totals, and the storm surge from that onshore flow certainly enhancing any of that any tidal issues as well. In our side of the state, we're looking at the I-75 corridor, a half an inch to an inch of rain, certainly what we can handle. As far as winds go, the strongest winds, of course, are going to be closer to the center of the storm. So the east coast of Florida, looking at seeing some tropical storm force winds up to hurricane Cat 1 to Cat 2, most likely wind gusts along that side of the coast. Here on our side, though, we're not going to see much of anything when it comes to tropical storm force winds, with the exception of Polk and Highlands counties. Our coastline may see something along the lines of 25 to 35 mile per hour gusts for a period of time on Tuesday or Wednesday morning. But otherwise, those strong winds, the 57 mile per hour wind gusts tomorrow morning in the Palm Beach County, and then it will continue working its way north throughout the day on Wednesday as that storm continues to make its path north in the Atlantic. By Thursday afternoon, the winds all start to come back down across the entire state. Now, we do have various watches and warnings across the east coast of Florida as far as our viewing area is concerned. Stern, still Polk and Highlands County are the only two that are under that tropical storm watch due to its proximity to the center of the storm, where they could see those tropical storm force winds, which means anywhere from about 40 mile per hour to 60 mile per hour gusts are what are a possibility right now for Polk and Highlands. At this point in time, wind gusts have been anywhere around 20 to 25 miles per hour, so nothing extreme going on out there right now for sure. And again, we will have our round of showers and storms later on this afternoon, but at this point, we're just seeing a little bit of those outer rain bands working their way across and into possibly Sumter County over the next half hour. But as we take a wider look, you can see that there are some rain bands already working their way across the 95 corridor and into Highlands County as well, seeing a few of those showers, but nothing extreme at this point. Over the next couple of days, we'll continue to see a mix of some sun and clouds. Winds will be enhanced, like we talked about, and highs are going to be in the low 90s. Our rain coverage, though, really isn't going to get that high. Today we may see the highest coverage out of the next 3 days, but we will at least from time to time get those outer bands that rotate through. By next weekend, we're back to a pretty typical summertime pattern.
We won't promise you a free roof, and we have no interest in fake storm claims. We won't trick you by marking our prices way up just to mark them down. We don't cut corners with supervision or our installation process. At Collis Roofing, you can count on a free, no-nonsense estimate at fair price for exceptional workmanship with on-site supervision and the highest quality product. We invite you to experience the Collis Roofing difference today. Stop in, give us a call, or visit us at collisroofing.com.